Here in the UK, we do love a period property.
Did you ever think, Paul, that that might be ours?
From countryside houses...
God, it is huge, isn't it?
..to magnificent mansions.
It's so nice. It's lovely.
But beneath the grand facades...
The Lord and Lady with their castle.
..these derelict houses... ..are falling to bits.
Nice that the curtains are still hanging, eh?
Pushing away at that there, you can see it's just absolutely rotten.
All over the country, these historic homes...
This wallpaper was on the Titanic.
..are being snapped up at knockdown prices.
I don't think we ever imagined that we would be able to afford something of this stature.
But there are great challenges ahead.
Every single day, it's a new crisis to deal with.
I'm budgeted for a roof, I'm budgeted for a floor.
It's just everything at the moment. It's all too much.
For this growing army of brave and determined dreamers who want to transform these wrecks into the forever home of their dreams.
This is my favourite room.
The whole concept of the room and how it's come together.
I don't think I've really appreciated this room until now. Now it's finished.
Brick by brick.
I honestly never thought this day was going to come. I can't believe like we're actually at this point.
Room by room.
Absolutely love it.
We are a renovation nation. After their show-stopping kitchen renovation earlier in the week, today Anoushka and Greg's Cornish renovation continues as they jump in at the deep end with their dining room design.
There's going to be all sorts of, like, sea creatures in here. Some of the sea creatures will kind of be coming off the wall.
We're back with Matt and Michelle, and work moves up a gear.
Right then, Mish. I'm going in.
As they clear the old milking parlour.
That one wasn't easy.
A bit harder?
Yeah, definitely.
And Faye and David's 1930s mansion is leaking water...
It is dripping like that.
It's getting worse by the minute.
..and cash.
It's going to be more than we thought.
We've got food in our bellies. We definitely always think it's going to be OK.
On the glorious northern Cornish coastline, just a stone's throw from the clear blue sea, sits Penally House. Built in 1836, its new owners, Anoushka Lancaster, an interior designer, and her husband Greg, a design printer, plan to give the 19th century house a colourful makeover, turning it into a modern family home.
I think that we have to embrace the history of the house and we have to honour the house. But at the same time, we as a family have to have our stamp on it. And I really believe that you have to show your personality on your decor. You know, when you open a front door, you should know whose house that is. It's a bit like opening someone's wardrobe.
The couple paid £1 million for the 18-room house and have already gone to town transforming the kitchen, which now has a beautiful central island and a statement dusty pink oven. Next, they plan to make a big splash in the dining room.
So this is the dining room. We have grand plans for it. Hopefully an under-the-sea kind of theme, so it's going to be quite dark and moody. There's going to be all sorts of, like, sea creatures in here, and then some of the sea creatures will kind of be coming off the wall.
It certainly is an off-the-wall idea, and it'll be the job of design printer Greg to bring it to life.
I will cut out the characters onto alternative substrates and use then wall buffers to then bring those off, so the characters then become a 3D element with the wallpaper behind. So that's the thinking.
You lost me at substrate.
Basically creating a giant 3D painting on a wall.
Well, I can't wait to see this. Anoushka and Greg have commissioned London-based artist Christiana to create the sea creature design, which will then be scaled up for the dining room wall.
Scale is actually my absolute favourite to work in, and especially with the engravings, because they're so detailed.
And today they're at Christiana's studio to get their first glimpse of her design.
Hello!
Hi! How are you?
This is so exciting!
Are you supposed to look at this?
I know, I don't know if we're supposed to see this yet.
Oh my gosh, I'm totally blown away.
It's amazing, absolutely incredible.
Do you know what I love about your work is the more you look, you see something new every time. Like, I could look at this all day and still see new characters. And I love the fact that you've got butterflies under the sea. It's just so magical.
So we'll essentially be able to repeat this base on the four walls. But then around the fireplace and around, like, the windows, we'll go with shorts of fish. And, so it all four walls feel very different. Yeah.
And, you know, we were in two minds whether to go for the blue sea or the pink sea. Yes. But actually, do you know, I think the pink is so much more powerful when it's in smaller elements. We wanted it to feel, like, quite moody as well in there, like it's a dining room, like, for entertaining, so that these brighter characters will really sort of light up.
This is a very unusual commission.
Unusual, to say the least.
I'm very excited by your imagination.
Nothing's ever straightforward.
Thank you so much.
The seascape is everything Anoushka dreamed of, but the pressure's now on design printer Greg to turn those dreams into reality.
To imagine that being on such a huge scale in our dining room is quite mind-blowing.
I'm going to have a major drama in my studio, 3D scanning that. You've got no idea the lengths that's going to take to try and get it done.
It's so exciting.
Here's hoping the fishy design doesn't leave them all out at sea. Over 130 miles away is the historic county of Monmouthshire, where, hidden in the outskirts of the town of Caerleon, lies Clomendy Wood Manor. An arts and crafts house taking inspiration from centuries past, but built little more than 100 years ago. And it's now the proud home of event caterers Faye and David.
We eventually got the house for £940, which I think is an absolute bargain.
It's,
It's so beautiful, like the work that's gone into this property. When you come and see this place and you drive up the driveway, it's magical, isn't
it? It's magic.
To afford the restoration, they plan to rent some of it out as a luxury holiday home, but it's far from ready. Earlier this week, David and Faye started expensive work updating their water supply, which has now diluted their 80 grand budget. Today, they're turning their attention to the restoration of one of the bedrooms and bathrooms, ready for paying guests.
Lovely colour. It's come out brown.
But with water like that, you'd get out dirtier than when you got in. To keep costs down, David's drafted in friend and fellow chef, Des, to help remove the first bathroom suite, ready for restoration.
You don't really want to be spending a lot of money paying a plumber to take all of this apart when their skill is really in putting it back together. So, as many of these jobs that I can do, get done.
Plumbers charge a lot an hour, so.
Good job, but you only want a fiver, innit, Dad?
£2 more than what he pays me cooking.
I was going to say pour that down the sink, but...
While the ancient plumbing will be upgraded, all original features in the bathroom will be carefully restored. And that goes for the century-old bedroom doors, which Faye hopes to bring back to life with varnish stripper.
The vibe is, put it on thick, hope for the best. Try not to die, don't drink it.
A good plan so far.
I don't want to change too much about them, you know, that will change the look of the house. I'm just trying to get it a little bit lighter so that it doesn't feel so dark. If it doesn't work, then Dave gets his way, which is to paint them all.
The arts and crafts movement embraced natural wood as a mark of beauty. But with 30 doors to tackle, the job requires a little patience.
It's not the miracle that I was hoping for. I was hoping for a, wow, look, it's all come off, isn't that amazing?
Patience is also wearing thin in the bathroom.
What's this made of?
Cast iron.
They plan to respray the bath, but doing it in such a tight space will be tricky. So the boys need to move it into the bedroom for restoration.
Could we not just weigh this in and the boiler and then get you a new bath?
Want this bath.
A job which is proving even trickier.
Can we not take it all the way around so it's as it is? So this is over there.
It's not going out that door. Dave's not very good at spatial awareness.
I'll measure it one more time.
We got this, man. Come on.
I don't trust you too much.
Why not?
I don't. I hope that during the process of the renovation, I certainly learned to be more patient.
If you push it all the way up to the door, then you can slide out with me or not?
I just hope that we can learn to work together more easily when things are stressful.
Right. Just stop for a minute.
Can I just ask what you're trying to do?
I've got to work out how to get my head underneath it.
Because when things are stressful, you...
It's when things go wrong,
you
but...
just take, you obviously take it out of the person closest to you, because that's just the nature of the beast. Ow, 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 ow! Communicate! You can't just pull things. Yeah, my hand was right there.
With a little perseverance, the bath is removed with limbs and fingers mostly intact.
I'm going to drop it the last inch because my fingers are underneath it.
OK, you OK?
Whew. And no major disasters, at least for the moment. Coming up, there's good news for David and Faye.
First booking is in about 6 weeks' time. It's happening, so we'll just crack on and we'll get it done.
And bad news for Anoushka and Greg.
Worst case scenario, they slap me with an enforcement notice and ask all tradesmen to leave the site. That would be shocking.
Next, we head to Monmouthshire, which is the location of this six-bedroomed Grade II listed farmhouse. Having lain empty for 4 years, it was bought by former Welsh international rugby player Matt and his wife Michelle, a former GB Olympian triple jumper, who, despite its derelict state, thought they'd won gold when they snapped it up for £537,000.
When we first saw the farmhouse, it was a wow. You know, you walk in here and you think, oh, my gosh, this is the size, I think it's 6,000 square footage. And it's got two barns as well, which are completely derelict and run down. And it is the perfect location. It's a dream come true. And I feel very lucky for that.
After dealing with damp and fixing leaking chimneys in the main house, the couple have now turned their attention to the barns. And Michelle's long-term plan is to turn them into holiday lets and a wellness centre. But first, they're tackling the bit they can do themselves, which is clearing them out. While one barn has already been cleared, the other still resembles a full-on milking parlour packed with potentially hundreds of pounds worth of steel, which Matt's trying to get his hands on.
I tried to have a crack at it with some bolts and Allen keys and ratchets, and I couldn't get anywhere near it. They rusted too far in, so I completely underestimated the extent of what it is. So much so that I've got a slightly bigger axle grinder in the hope that I'll be able to do the job. I'm going to try this straight run here first, which I'm guessing was where the cows would have come in. These are the bays, I think. It's got to come out. It might be worth something. I don't know. But the only way I will know is to get it out and be able to put it on a lorry and get it weighed.
While Matt's trying to remove the metal, Michelle's got the glamorous job of removing muck and stuff.
Matt!
Yeah?
There's four dead hedgehogs here.
I saw them last time, Dave.
Yeah, and they're still here.
They're not going anywhere, miss. We've got to clean it at some point.
This is proper gross. Not sure this is my favourite job, I tell you.
There would have been up to 100 cows on this farm during its heyday, being milked 12 at a time in here. And clearing the barn is proving to be quite a workout for Olympian athlete Michelle.
Training's far easier than this.
Having failed to make a dent on the steel with normal tools, Matt's bringing up the big guns.
Right then, Mish.
Yes, babe.
I'm going in.
Right, just be careful, yeah?
Let's have a go and see what happens.
Stop a minute, what was it?
Cut him.
Did you cut it?
Yeah.
Maybe a bit of brute strength will speed things up. That's right, Matt, give it some welly.
Right, I get it.
How
How's it looking, babes?
Yeah, you'll see now.
Eventually, Matt's hoping he'll be able to convert this scrap into cash to help pay for the renovation.
It seems to be doing it, so slowly, slowly, right?
Matt, that's brilliant.
Now, that's satisfying, isn't it?
Yeah, very. We're here for how long we're here, just trying to do our thing slowly and controlled, and hopefully we'll be all right. Think we're getting there.
Matt, well done, Bev. I love the fact you've done that.
So I think I could go over there now and do the other ones.
Let me just put this
in the same sort of way. That one wasn't easy.
Bit harder?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, it's been great to get my hands on today. Maybe it takes me back to my rugby days where it's been physical and hard work, actually. Holding that grinder's not been easy. Nearly there, babe, nearly there.
So much better, though.
Done it?
Yeah. This is your little keepsake, right, Matt?
Yeah, please. That has to go above the door somewhere, yeah? Good luck.
So good luck, chum.
Upside down horseshoes.
But we're lucky already.
We're lucky that we got the place.
Yeah, we're lucky already.
That's why we keep finding little gems like that.
After 3 hours of hard graft, Matt has removed a hefty amount of steel from the outside walls, and Michelle's removed some muck and a few departed hedgehogs.
This was definitely the right tool for this, just getting it done. Just ripping it. I mean, there was times in that I was ripping out those blue troughs.
Yeah.
Oh, what fun that was. I'd just snap nipple fiberglass on it. It was great fun. No Allen key was getting them out, I don't think.
You're such a nah.
Yeah. And good luck.
And with a renovation project of this scale, they're going to need all the luck they can get. Back at Penally House in Cornwall.
In we go.
Work on Anoushka and Greg's sea creature-themed dining room continues. And today, designer Christiana is on site.
She's only seen it on flat images, so for her to get a feeling of the room's really, really important today.
Originally, it was going to be a simple process of just taking an original painting, scanning it and turning it to wallpaper. And now it's evolved even further to a live room of art.
Well, I wouldn't know whether to hang it, swim in it or fish in it.
Hey,
come on in for the destruction. But yeah, so this is the room.
Super excited. What I'm really excited about is the detailing around the windows. It didn't quite convey in the pictures that I saw.
Yeah.
So this makes it like doubly exciting because we can really lift it. It can carry so much more than what I thought.
And it's so good to be here before we scan so that we can visualise when we're there, scale and where we want the different characters, which walls we want them on.
Yeah, I think definitely a stingray and a shark. But I think then also the shoal of fish.
I can't wait to see all the colours on the screen, like, once it's scanned.
The next step on this creative journey is to try to turn Christiana's 3D pictures into wallpaper. It'll be the first chance to see if Anoushka's slightly out there idea works.
It needs to be elegant as well as adventurous. But, I mean, thank God that this house, the room, the structure, the coving, everything is giving it a really nice frame, which is allowing us to be more adventurous. It's definitely not going to be everybody's style, but that's what I love about them. They're quite fearless in this way. So when an opportunity like that comes along, you know, to really experiment, you can't let that go.
As well as putting their own stamp on the house, the couple are rewiring, replumbing, replacing broken windows and restoring original features throughout, like ceiling roses and decorative lintels. This style was heavily influenced by the architecture of ancient Greece and Rome and used by the Georgians to add interest to ceilings and walls.
That was the template shape for over the top of the doorways, but they actually make the silicon mould. We've got one, two, three up, two more to go.
But as Penally House is Grade 2 listed, adaptations, alterations and renovations are governed by legal restrictions. And now Greg could be facing a problem. Some of the work they've already carried out, including their completed kitchen, might need listed building consent, and the council are on their case.
There's over 12,000 heritage properties listed in Cornwall, so hopefully, based on my discussions with them, they'll be very pleased with what we're doing, because they've had a few shockers in their last couple of years especially. Best case scenario, very, very content with what we're doing and put a further application in with regards to the renovation work we're doing. Worst case scenario, they slap me with an enforcement notice and ask all the tradesmen to leave the site and they'll come and reassess. So that would be shocking, because I will lose probably 3-4 months.
This could spell disaster for Anoushka and Greg's reno plans.
Right, phone the boss.
But he's just had word from the council, so he's calling Anoushka at work to tell her what's happening.
Hello.
Hello, hello, how you doing?
Yeah, good. How's it all gone?
80% positive, 20% negative. So they're delighted with what we're doing, but they said, in theory, we should have been shut down today and everyone off-site pending an application for renovation, not repair and maintenance.
But even taking out awful things that were added in without permission from the 1990s?
Yep, everything, yeah, everything. Rewiring the whole house would be an application. Bad news is, and we need to file a specific application for it, is the window. It should all be clear glass only.
What?
Yeah.
That's not what it was originally. The border would have definitely been a colour, otherwise it wouldn't be like that now with the broken ones.
You're going to have to fight your corner then with them with regards to what you wish to do.
Greg and Anoushka can apply for planning retrospectively, so the renovation can continue. But preparing paperwork will cost them nearly £10,000, an unexpected hit to the budget. And in Monmouthshire, the forecast isn't looking great for Faye and David either.
Look at that. Yeah, so it's hitting this piece of wood and kind of spreading out, I guess.
The unexpected downpour is the result of a leak in their bathroom. Well, most of us would expect to have the odd shower in there, I suppose.
We've got up this morning to soggy carpets downstairs. We've not really been through and noticed it until today. And fingers crossed it'll be easy to fix.
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed, it is dripping like mad.
It's getting worse by the minute.
Hoping to bring their wet spell to an end, David and his friend Des find the source of the problem.
It's coming out quite quick. I'd quite like to get in behind it, so I might knock away a bit this plaster.
It seems a pipe may have been dislodged when they removed the bathroom suite 2 days ago.
You can just see the water line every time I dab it away, very slowly, raising there. Just that persistent tiny bit of water left for a few days, and the area it's covered downstairs is huge.
Luckily, Des is on hand to make sure David turns the nuts in the right direction.
Lefty loosey, righty tight.
Yeah. I've just given it one twist to see if that'll just tighten it up on this joint and save us having to ring a plumber today.
There's at least half a day here. So 5 hours, 300 quid, I would have said.
If you're lucky.
If we're...
Yeah.
So just by being gentle with it, giving it a quick tweak, hopefully we've saved ourselves 300 quid.
That is a win. Go and tell Faye it's still leaking.
Pipes tightened and fingers crossed. With the bedroom protected with masking film, the next job is to restore the original cast iron bath.
People don't make things like they used to. So it's fantastic to just keep a bit of that history in the house.
With a dwindling budget, it's vital they complete the bedroom and bathroom soon to rent out to paying guests.
The money we had in the bank for the renovation is being spent on things that we didn't expect it to be, so it's quite important for us to start making a bit of money back by getting people in. The original aim was to have a place ready for the summer, then I found out that our first booking is in about 6 weeks' time.
it's happening, so we'll just crack on and we'll get it done.
Right. Moment of truth, isn't it?
Now the bath is rubbed down, the boys use a spray gun for an even finish. Firstly, they apply a coat of primer before coating it in Faye's bold colour choice.
Result. Pink bath. Amazing. Yeah, really happy.
I'd be tickled pink with that, but will Faye?
You come to see the bath?
Yeah.
What do you think?
It's very pink. I think because it's so big, you kind of look at it and thinking, wow, that is pink.
I was hoping for a bit of a better reaction to that.
I was saying how pink's not really your thing.
You just got to style it out. I think that's all right, isn't it? Yeah. Pink was the colour that I chose, so it's
no,
not...
No, definitely.
You know, it's not a surprise that it's pink. It looks great.
Coming up, will Greg manage to scale up Anoushka's fishy design?
Yeah, nervous. I think it's going to be hard, because when you look at that, it's a lot of detail.
And Matt and Michelle are getting plastered.
One, two, three, up. Right, stop screwing.
In Cornwall, at Penally House, the bare walls of the dining room will soon be filled with pictures of exotic sea creatures. Today, the artwork for the 3D wallpaper has been taken to Greg's printing studio.
I don't know which door he wants us to go in.
This is the interesting bit, to see actually whether it's going to work. So, we'll see. We never quite know until we do it.
Okay.
Christiana's sea creature collage will be scanned by Greg's state-of-the-art 3D scanner.
I'm comfortable now. I know exactly what I'm doing, that's why. I'm in charge. Never happens on the renovation.
We probably have to do a little bit of photoshopping because we have been just working on this area and stuff.
But when Greg sees the final design...
A bit worried.
Are you?
Yeah.
What are you worried about?
Well, there's the level of depth, really, and the scanner.
If the scanner can't picture the layers in Christiana's collage, Anoushka and Greg's SeaWorld wallpaper might sink like the Titanic.
Will it go straight to the screen?
It will do, yeah.
There we go.
Woohoo!
Yeah, nervous. I think it's going to be hard. Because when you look at that, it's a lot of detail.
But Greg's trepidation is short-lived. Phew.
That's so cool.
That's better than I thought it would be for first attempt. So that was a pleasing result, because there's so much layering there.
By superimposing the scanned artwork onto a CGI drawing of their dining room walls, they get a tantalising glimpse of what the finished room could look like.
The other shell to go that way.
Yes.
Yeah. This is great for me. This is when it comes to life. To see yes. whether it's going to work or not.
Yes.
Because it could look hideous. But
no, it won't look hideous. It's going to look amazing. I think just seeing the painting actually taking up a whole wall, like the whole room is like you're stepping into a piece of art.
Yes.
To be able to visualise that is incredible.
Very happy. Definitely the 3D scan's going to work.
At Penally House, the renovation is on schedule. The only sticking point is getting listed building consent from the council. Greg and Anoushka have employed a heritage consultant to make sure the plans they submit are historically accurate.
It's a bit of a minefield. We don't really know what we are applying for because we're not sure what we are allowed and what we're not allowed to do.
The council are particularly concerned about the arched windows on the landing.
There was confusion with the council because they thought we wanted to replace the actual window, which we don't want to replace. It's an original sash. We just want to replace the glass. So I think it's going to be great having Jenna with us to maybe advise us on what it would have been and what they are going to be open to us doing. The main feature really is this huge window, which I'll show you up here, which is like the main stress of the whole house.
we want to change this textured glass, which to me looks like bathroom glass. I mean, it's a really strange choice. So to make that clear, and then just have a uniform approach to all of the border.
So what are you thinking in terms of colours?
We found a glass that was like hand blown. I can send you a picture. It's all different colours in one, and we would just use that all the way around.
Right. Okay.
So it's just quite uniform, right. But it's got lots of different colours in it.
Yeah. No, I'd love to see that.
Yeah, yeah.
And as long as you know what you're putting in there is sensitive to the historic fabric of the building, yeah. And you're not affecting the timbers or you know the proportions of the window yeah. itself.
In your opinion, how long do you think it will take for them to make a decision?
It's a problem, but I'd say you're looking at least 8 weeks.
Really? That's the best case scenario. Jenna told me that quite often the council have shut down renovation projects and the council didn't want to do that, and she said that's a really good sign.
Jenna will now help Anoushka and Greg prepare the planning application to the council. Having her on board will help show that the work being done here preserves the architectural history of the house.
The stained glass, that's really interesting because Jenna didn't like what was there at all and was in total agreement that that needs to be changed. The only frustration from this meeting is that it sounds like every decision takes weeks, and I think we're just going to have to accept that.
In South Wales, after milking the parlour of its steel to generate some cash, Matt and Michelle are now tackling some DIY in the main house, in a room which Matt has earmarked as his office, come man cave.
So our next thing for today is Matt wants us to put up some plasterboards and insulation. He's trying to prep it and it's something we've never done, but again, you know, we're all for being the first. So yeah, it's good.
Can't be so difficult, man. I've done this so many times.
I think he's struggling with the Stanley knife at the moment, so excuse the expletives. I think he's a bit frustrated. We've all been there.
I think I just done it.
You done it?
I think. We'll find out.
The blade is to cut down insulation they're planning to fit between the beams before boarding them over. It'll make Matt and Michelle's home more energy efficient, and it'll protect the office against the cold in the winter and excessive heat in the summer.
We could go now, right? Effectively, we could go the whole length of the 2.4 now.
Ooh, what a noise. Oh, my God.
That's all right, don't worry about that. It's nice and tight, it's good.
Oh dear.
And then we'll cut this or patch this.
I think there should be a better way to cut it, Matt. Like a knife or something. This is a bit rubbish.
Taking Michelle's advice on board, Matt supersizes his tool.
Clever.
Work starts to speed up.
Do you want me to hold that? Something.
All right.
There you go, you're in.
That's great.
Yeah, it's better.
Right, I'm done. Let's get the plasterboard in.
But getting the mammoth sheet of plasterboard up is easier said than done.
It's not light.
Once it's in and pushed against that, we'll be all right.
All right.
1, 2, 3, up. You there?
Yeah. Right.
Right, start screwing.
They manage to get one sheet up before they have to down tools and head back to Devon, leaving the rest to their team of builders. And just 10 days later, the builders have finished what Matt and Michelle started. The whole ceiling is up and plastered. The lights are in and pipework fitted for where the radiators will go. It's the first room that's really beginning to take shape.
The one where we were doing the ceiling?
Yeah.
so.
Oh, they plastered it and everything. This is wicked. And you got lights. Bring me light. Matt, we did this, you know. Matt, I'm not sure about this for your office, you know. I think you're being a bit greedy.
No, it's my office. Oh. That's it.
TV here still?
Yeah, I think my TV there. I think my TV there. And I think probably my desk here.
Okay.
Yeah, near to the window. I see my little spaces, my little place of solitude. I can just come and just be me. They'd be great.
Love these. Again, but the plastering, man.
Yeah, well, it's just very, very good.
And you can also say that your wife helped you put up your scene.
Yeah, well, you know, look, here's the ones we did and stuff, you know. And the boys just said, you know what, man, it's still up there.
So it's nearly one room down, only another 9 to go. Coming up, will Faye and David's bedroom and bathroom be ready for their booking?
Sort of feels finished-ish.
Yeah, liquor paint.
Fixtures. That's it.
And has Anoushka pulled off her deep-sea dining room design?
Bonkers to a degree, but it's got quite a nice sense of calmness to it as well.
At Clemendy Wood Manor in Monmouthshire, after 3 months of hard graft, Faye and David's century-old bathroom is ready for paying guests.
Oh, it looks nice, doesn't it?
Well, almost.
Sort of feels finished-ish.
Yeah, liquor paint.
Decorating, finishing, fixtures. That's it.
The ensuite now oozes classic Art Deco style with opal-glazed brick tiles and unmistakable additions from the decadent era to complete the look.
I'm in love with the tiles. They were the right choice. It's really lovely that we're at the start of the vibe that we're going to go with. Like, I'm particularly excited that we saved the taps because I think they're really beautiful. What's the point of replacing something that's original? That's so lovely, isn't it? And I think that radiator's lovely, and just all those things that we've been able to keep that are original to the room, I think, are amazing.
But perhaps David's proudest restoration achievement is the work to bring the original cast iron bathtub back to life.
I think the bath is amazing. Whoever painted it is an absolute legend. Like, particularly the inside of the bath, the paint's worked well.
I mean, it looks amazing. There is no knocking it. Like, the job is fantastic.
Meanwhile, in the bedroom, what was once a slightly dated boudoir, not exactly to Faye and David's taste, is now...
Look at this! Ta-da!
Exactly the same.
So, we haven't done anything.
The carpet needs to come up, the floor needs sanding back and varnishing.
We were going to do some panelling here, like beautiful Art Deco panelling. Need to take off the horrible things on the curtains. Even just the little diamonds would be enough to make it look less awful. It's not a lot, is it? But I didn't want to put loads of new stuff in here whilst they're still trashing the bathroom. It's just taken, like, literally 4 times longer than it should have done.
But the realities of a renovation project this size means nothing really goes to schedule. So they've had to make a very difficult decision.
We had to cancel the guests that were booked in, and we had to stop, obviously, taking any more bookings. We just took a complete block on that. And much as we needed the money, there's no way that we could have got it done. But we do need to start getting people in.
But that won't be any time soon. Faye and David have another issue, which is yet to be resolved. The water pressure.
The water's still got a slight brown tinge.
They've had some quotes for the work needed to complete the building of a new tank and filtration system, and the price was a nasty surprise.
We started with £15,000 for the water.
Yeah.
The quote's about £20,000 on top of the £7,000 we've already spent. We can go and find somebody else who can possibly come up with a simpler solution. It's just the time.
We've run out of time.
Yeah, and we can't have people stay in the house with the water pressure.
No, of course we can't. Like, that for me, that's off the table now. Yeah. Until Christmas.
Faye and David will be without an income from their rooms for at least 6 months. And with costs for other parts of the renovation increasing,
It was boiler or electrics. We'd set aside about 20.
Yeah.
Drive was a third more.
Yeah.
Cash is running dry.
It's going to be more than we thought. We'll have to wait until we've got a bit more in the bank.
It's about mindset, isn't it? You can just crack on. And I think that's it, isn't it? I think that we are overall really quite positive people, maybe blindly optimistic.
And we're blessed. We might live in a building site, but we live in a building site in beautiful countryside.
We've also got food. We've got food in our bellies. We're still lucky. There's a lot of people a lot worse off, aren't there? We definitely always think it's going to be okay, don't we?
Yeah.
With a bit of determination and a slice of luck, hopefully things will have moved on for Faye and David's reno when we next see them. Over on the south coast in Cornwall, Anoushka and Greg's deep-sea dining room is finally finished. 6 months ago, the room was beige and a bit boring. Now, it's anything but. With colourful 3D sea creatures swimming up the walls, it's a one-off transformation.
Finished room. Absolutely love it.
Bonkers to a degree, but it's got quite a nice sense of calmness to it as well.
Yeah.
I'm chuffed. I love it.
I love it too.
Anoushka's artistic eye and Greg's printing know-how have created a wallpaper with a lifelike effect.
It does look like the wall's got a ripple to it. And I just think that whole adds to the whole movement and flow of the ocean, really. So I'm chuffed a bit.
They've even added larger fish mounted in clear acrylic to create another layer.
Everyone said, don't do the characters. It's going to be a little bit too much. But, you know, I think it's absolutely perfect. I love the characters. I think they're absolutely epic.
And what I love about this room is that every time I come in here, I spot something new. There's a little pink stingray down here that I hadn't seen before, and this little frog who is so gorgeous. And I think that's what's so amazing about this room.
There's a butterfly. Pink butterfly.
We're just going to keep doing this now. Look. Oh, gosh, yeah.
Alongside the immersive wallpaper, they've preserved or reinstated the original Georgian features, which go together swimmingly.
We've got this incredible ornate ceiling, which, I mean, for me, that was worth that part of the investment.
Seven layers to spray it, I think. I think it's the perfect twist. We wanted the heritage with the twist of our colour and uniqueness, and I think this is absolutely tremendous.
And I decided to keep all the woodwork and the ceiling and everything white, and I'm really glad that we have, because I think it really frames the artwork. It was a really difficult thing as well, finding the chandelier that was right for the room, because we didn't want it to compete with the wallpaper. And that with the antique mirror, the really, really old antique mirror, they match in colour, but they're so contrasting. It's got a nod to the heritage of the house. It's got a nod to the location of the house because it's, you know, by the sea. I just think it ticks every box.
Anoushka and Greg have certainly created a splash in the dining room, and hopefully the effects will ripple throughout the renovation of the rest of the house.
Every time you come in and look at the walls, it's incredible, so...
I think it's going to be really fun.
Thought we'd make the wallpaper really busy so it distracts people from our really bad cooking.
My really bad cooking? Yeah, you're fine. Yeah.
Later this week, Matt and Michelle find that drive and determination run in the family.
That's my girl.
But next time, Faye and David have to make do and mend as cash runs out for their renovation.
It's going to save us money. It's just more time and more work.
If you want less time and less work, we should have bought a non-crazy house.
The courageous creatives, Anoushka and Greg, make bold moves in the boudoir.
That colour's gorgeous, which is obviously a big worry, because it's a big thing to get wrong.
I'm not sure it's pink enough.
And for better...
Wow, it's just beautiful.
And for worse...
Why can't men just wee in the toilet?
We're back in North Yorkshire as Naomi and Byron get rooms ready for their brides and grooms.
Tonight, making use of all the space on offer, a slither of garden down the side of the house makes for a beautifully crafted grand design at 9. Bags packed and ready to check in to 4 in a bed, coming next.